Okay, so let's think about the Six Sigma quality. Six Sigma quality is very broad and complex concept, but generally speaking, you can understand Six Sigma in three different ways. You know, Six Sigma can be understood from the statistical point of view. You can simply define Six Sigma quality in a way that Six Sigma reproduced around 3.4 defects per million opportunities. So defect per million opportunities we call DPMO, which I will explain later. But simply you can understand that Six Sigma quality produced 3.4 defects per million opportunities. That's the statistic, you know, perspective of Six Sigma. The other way of understanding Six Sigma is this a process. It is ongoing, the continuous improvement process. So defining customer requirements and measuring the process, analyzing the output and improving the performance and controlling what has been improved. Those define the DMAIC approach is the usual way of measuring the ongoing process of Six Sigma. And then finally, Six Sigma can be understood as a philosophy. Anything less than idea or anything less than being perfect is an opportunity for improvement. Defects cost money. So philosophy and culture, the highest quality culture and philosophy that companies are pursuing. This is the way you can understand Six Sigma. So Six Sigma can be a statistics. It can be a process, it can be a philosophy. Let's briefly talk about how we understand Six Sigma from statistical point of view. Okay, here you see the normal standard deviation, normal standard distribution with a bell shape. Usually this normal distribution table distribution has mean and standard deviation. As you know, the sigma indicates standard deviation, and normally the company set the 3 ± 3 standard deviation as the quality standard. When they set 3 standard deviation, then they allow the 2700 defect per million opportunities. So this area combined, 2700 defects can be allowed per million opportunities. Whereas when companies set 6 standard deviation plus minus 3 standard deviation, they only allow this much combined 3.4 defects per million opportunities. So in other words, the with a 6 standard, 6 sigma level, companies are capable of producing 99.9997% are capable of producing desired outcomes. So as you see that the big difference between 3 sigma and 6 sigma qualities. So that's why 6 sigma quality is really highest level of quality standards. So Six Sigma quality allows only 3.4 defects per million opportunities, or 3.4 DPMO. That's the usual way of defining Six Sigma quality. One way to measure the Six Sigma quality is using DPMO, as I said. DPMO is the defect per million opportunities, the number of defects divided by number of opportunities for error per unit times unit number of unit. Usually number of unit is equal to 1, so you don't have to consider that, times million times. So unit is the item produced or being serviced. So it can be applied both manufacturing and service industries. Defect is any item or event that does not meet customer requirements. Because Six Sigma is all about meeting customer requirements. But if it does not meet customer requirement, that's regarded as defect. And opportunity is the chance for a defect to occur. So having said this concept, let's go through the problems. This is the, say, mortgage application, you know, problem. So in this case, mortgage application process should be done within 10 days of filing. So less than 10 days of filing, then that's good for customers. So, you know, from Six Sigma point of view, that's the, you know, normal product. But if it process is over 10 days, say more taking more than 10 days process, that's regarded as defect. And then it is determined that there are 150 loans in 1,000 applications processed last month that does meet this customer requirement. So we have a based on this you know formula, DPMO equals 150, which is the number of defect, divided by 1,000 application, number of opportunity for error per unit, times 1, number of unit is 1, times the million opportunities. So 150,000 loans, these are the, you know, defective loans out of million, every million processed that failed to meet critical customer requirement. So it's a pretty significant defective rate, which is 15%. It's defective rate, and 85% are correct. So only 850,000 loans out of million are approved within time specifications. So that's the one way to measuring the, you know, Six Sigma quality. Let's have another problem. This is about the so manager state that his process is really working well. So out of 1500 part, 1477 were produced free of particular defect, passed the inspection. So based on the Six Sigma theory, how you rate this performance other than being equal? So manager think that, okay, the process is really good, but let's examine based on the Six Sigma theory of DPMO, whether this process is good or bad. So this is the formula. So each of the 1500 units either pass or fails with one opportunity for errors. So defect would be 1500 minus 1477. So 23 is a defect, number of defect, divided by the total number opportunity for error per unit is 1500, and then one unit, number of unit is 1, times million, which is 15,333. What do you think? This is a DPMO. This is the defect, more than the 15,000 defect per million opportunities. So regardless of what managers think, this process is really not good in terms of Six Sigma theory. So we can say this is not so good process, need to be examined and improved if we want to, you know, live up to the Six Sigma quality. Okay, thank you.